Hi, I'm Chef Costa Magoulas, and on this episode, we're going to have a nutty time with pecans. So stay tuned for this episode of Local Flavor. Welcome to Local Flavor. On this episode, we soar to the treetops to bring you pecans. And here with us tonight, local pecan grower Mike Barrett. Mike, thank you very much for coming down to the show.
Hey, Chef. Thanks for having me tonight.
Well, I really appreciate you coming because, you know, people don't realize that pecans are grown in Florida.
They are. They're not grown to the degree they are in places like Texas and Georgia, but we do grow quite a bit here, up to 1 million pounds a year.
You know, how long have you been doing this?
Been at it about 10 years, 10 long years.
10 long years. Well, I noticed you brought some great product with you down there, but we're going to talk about that in a minute. So pecan has been in Florida for a long time?
Has been. One of the varieties that I grow is the Elliott variety, and it's been in this area. They discovered it here about 110 years ago.
Is that right? Mm-hmm. Well, we want to remind everybody, this is a call-in show, and we expect you to call in. So the number is 1-800-901-9238. 1-800-901-9238. Write that down now because we're expecting your calls. Mike would like to answer some calls on growing pecans. I'll talk to you about cooking. So here we're ready to roll here, okay? We're going to talk a little bit more about your pecan. And you have family operation. Does anybody help you with this?
I'm the Lone Ranger.
You're the Lone Ranger.
Just me.
Well, listen, we're going to take a little trip down to Mike's farm here in just a second. So let's take a look at your pecan farm down there and see how you do grow pecans.
Okay,
appreciate
great.
That. There it is.
Okay, this is a picture of my place. I've got about 70 trees spread over 4.5 acres.
What is that right there, Mike?
That's a nut that's been hit by scab.
We can
talk later about scab. It's a fungal issue that we deal with on a regular basis. That's a picture of fall webworms. I must get the all-season webworms at my place because I deal with them all year round. It's just one of those pests that we have to deal with and spray. I'm showing you my high-tech picking operation.
And you're doing that all by yourself,
I do it
right?
by myself.
No daughter or anything?
Well, that's not their thing. They're too busy doing something else.
Well, that shell, I just never saw pecans like that,
The nut grows inside of a shuck, that green
shuck
thing you see is a shuck, and that protects it, and it actually feeds the nut for the 6 months that the season is
that's
it's
amazing.
Growing.
I don't think many people have ever seen that.
Probably not.
What are we doing here?
Well, we're getting ready to see a demonstration of spraying. One of the most important things about growing pecans is you absolutely have to spray numerous times during the season.
What are you spraying for?
One of the most important things early in the season is zinc. Zinc is the growth catalyst for the tree, and if this tree is 80 feet high, you have to spray the zinc 80 feet high. So it's really important to get that on there. Otherwise, you won't have a crop.
That's amazing. You know, I've always heard that zinc is good for humans, too. But, you know, that thing looks like it's really putting out some pressure when it blows
It does. It's called a cannon sprayer, and it does put out quite a force, but it does not knock the trees off, the nuts off the tree, no.
Does the weather really affect you badly here, cold, warm?
It does a dramatic impact on the operation, mostly because of the humidity. As we get into the rainy season and the humidity picks up, it creates a scab on the tree, which has to be sprayed.
Boy, look at that thing blow.
Yeah.
That's just, you know, I just couldn't believe that when I saw that.
That's a good picture.
It really is. And that's your pecans right there, right?
Yeah, there's some of the finished product, if you will.
Well, I love this.
Now, yeah, just a quick demonstration of cracking, how we crack them, if we're just doing them a few at a time. I do have a heavy-duty cracker in the house, but I couldn't bring
right?
it. Yeah, it makes it a little bit easier.
We're going to do that on the show. I got to see that again.
Okay.
I wish I had one of those.
Yeah, that's called a goody getter, and you're definitely going to want one of those if you're one of those folks.
What's
that,
little tool?
It's called a goody getter, and because it's getting the goody out of the shell, and it makes it a lot easier on your hands if you've got one of those.
You know, those pecans look a lot different than the ones I get.
Yeah, you'll notice that they're creamy colored because they're fresh out of the shell. Most of the stuff that that you're buying at the store has been in the shell and probably, or it's been in the package for up to a year.
Well, that's amazing. So, well, we're going to look at that right now.
Yeah, okay.
Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. So we're waiting for your calls. Now, you brought these pecans with you here, and I noticed there's a little small one here, and
right.
the ones with the black. Can you tell us about the difference in these?
Yeah, the larger one is the variety is called Cape Fear. It originated in Cape Fear, North Carolina. And the smaller one, the teardrop one, is called an Elliott, and it originated right here in Milton, Florida, about 110 years ago.
Is that right?
Yes, it did.
Now, is there paper-thin pecans? I've heard that
term. Yes, you hear the term paper shell. That refers to the ease at which you can crack the shell. The large one here, the Cape Fear, is a paper shell, so it's very easy to crack that one up. Unfortunately, the smaller one is not.
Well, you were showing me the meat. This is what I got a big kick out of, is the color of the meat
right here.
Now, this is an older one. You said it's
a year old, and you can see the difference.
Boy, can you naturally see big difference
right.
in that.
And unfortunately, the one to the left, the darker one, is what most people get at the store because
they've been
in the package, and they've oxidized over the course of a year. They still taste good. They're just not as creamy, and the flavor isn't quite as robust as it is when they're fresh.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Yeah, it's a big difference.
That's pretty good. Well, we got a phone call. Hello, caller.
Hi, how are you doing?
From DeLand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. What's your question for us?
My question would be, what's the difference between buying pecans from a local grocery store?
Wait.
Or in the grocery store, from buying pecans locally or growing on a farm?
What do you think, Michael? We were just talking about that.
Yeah, well, it's like most things that you grow, that you can buy either in the store or fresh from the farm. You're just simply going to get a fresher product. That, and in this case, as we just showed, the creamy color of the pecan itself means it tastes much better than what you're going to get as it gets darker and gets drier.
Just get started.
It's just going to be a better product.
Both tasted pretty good.
Yes, they do taste good. I'm not saying they won't taste good. It's just that they'll taste much better.
I was messing around with them, but it really had a nice flavor to it. It was just lighter. It didn't taste as heavy. Well, tonight we're going to be cooking with pecans, and we're going to do some different things for you tonight. We're going to do praline bacon. Okay, folks, you like bacon? You're going to love this one. And we also have pecan tart we're going to make. And then we're going to do something savory tonight with pecans. We're going to do fettuccine Alfredo. And we're going to make it with pecans and all kinds of nice things. And then we're going to finish it up with a nice salad. We're going to make a dressing. We're going to use feta cheese. And we're going to put pecans in that and some fresh fruit. So let's get started with this pecan bacon here. Don't forget, 1-800-901-9238. We have another caller on the line. Hey, Paul from Apopka. How you doing, buddy? Hello, caller. Paul from Apopka. All right, what we do is, with this bacon, it's very simple. You take the bacon and put it in the oven, and you cook it till it's about halfway done. And this is what this is, and you take it out. Then you take brown sugar and pecans, you just put it in your blender mm-hmm. and make it real soft, and then you just pack it down like this. It's not hard. Now you got it all covered up real good. You put it back in the oven, and then our magic oven comes out over here, and here we have the pecan bacon already made up. That's what it looks like when it's finished up.
Looks good.
You want to try that?
Sure.
We got another caller, and it's from Melbourne, and the caller Shirley.
Looks good.
That tastes pretty good?
Mm, very good.
Can't hear you. Did we lose her? Oh, that's too bad. All right, we're going to keep going. We're going to go ahead and start cooking a little bit here. So we're looking at putting sugar. We're going to make this pecan tart. And it's just like making a pecan pie, but we're not going to stick it in the oven. So here we go. We put this right on. So all that's in here is sugar. And I'm going to turn this thing up. That looks pretty simple, doesn't it, Mike?
Mm-hmm.
And you said Georgia was the top?
Georgia's the top. 75% of the crop is grown in in Georgia, Texas, and New Mexico.
Is that right?
Yes.
Now, I'm going to put a little bit of lemon juice in here. I'm going to put it all over the place, actually. Put a little lemon juice in there. That's it. And then I'm going to start heating this thing up. And this sugar is going to melt down into like a caramel. And it's starting to kind of kick up a little bit. So this will keep cooking. You know, I was talking to you earlier about what's the most popular nuts. And I think they came up with that pecans are like number two in the country or something for pecans.
Probably just depends on the time of the year. This time of year, I would imagine that pecans are the most, the one people want more than any because it's that, you know, the holidays. People eat them a lot during the holidays.
I love pecans. You can put it in almost anything. I do like pancakes. I do got savory dishes like you do. Mm-hmm. To me, it's just sweeter than like walnuts and other nuts,
right.
You know, that type of thing. And this is starting to melt down a little bit. It takes a couple minutes for this to cook, but it's not hard to do, folks. We're just going to keep cooking it. Don't forget our... Hello, we got our caller back on the line from Melbourne. Shirley?
Yes.
Hey! What's your question for us?
Whereabouts are you located? I grew up in the Tom's area in Oklahoma.
Oh, okay. Right? Where are you located at, Mike?
We're in DeLand, north of DeLand, just a few miles north of DeLand. And I know that they grow quite a bit of pecans up in Oklahoma, so that is definitely pecan country.
I never thought of Oklahoma for pecans.
Mm-hmm.
Is that mostly in the South somewhere?
Well, yes. Yeah, so there's what we call the pecan belt, which is most of the Southeast, plus California. There's quite a bit grown in California as well.
We have another caller on the line, and that was, I didn't quite get where he's from or they're from. Caller, are you there? What's your question for us?
Yeah, hi. This is Brent from Winter Park.
Oh, hey, Brent. How you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you?
You cold over there?
Oh, yeah. You must believe. Hey, listen. My question is, I get a lot of friends that send me some pecans from Louisiana, and I wanted to know, how do you keep them stored to keep the flavor and the nutrition of those pecans?
Well, you can actually freeze them, keep them at 0 degrees for up to 2 years, and they'll be fine. Or you can keep them, honestly, I keep them in the house at room temperature, and they're fine for up to a year. Now, if I kept them a little bit cooler, my guess is the taste would be a little more robust than it is now. But again, you can either freeze them and keep them at 0 degrees for up to 2 years, or just simply keep them at room temperature, and they'll last probably 6 to 12 months.
That's amazing. I never realized they would last that long.
Mm-hmm.
But we're really getting down on this caramel. You get this up close, you see how it's really caramelizing. And the recipe's coming up. It's 2 pounds. You can cut this recipe in half if you like. It's 2 pounds of sugar, a little bit of lemon juice, heavy cream, love that. 10 ounces of unsalted butter, and 1 pound of chopped pecans. Then you have to get some tart shells, which we already have here. And then what you do is you add and whip it up real, real, real good. Then I made some whipped cream to top it with. But if you can see right now, this is getting into a nice caramel color. And I don't want to cook it too much more because then it starts getting bitter. And what I'm going to do is bring it right over here. And we'll take our cream and add that right to it. It's a real simple dish. I mean, you sit there and say, wow. Now this is going to start cooking up.
You make that look easy.
It is. It's not that hard. It really isn't. It's Jane from Palm Coast. We've got another caller. What's your question for us?
Yes, I was going to ask Mike about the...
Ask Mike what?
I was going to ask Mike about the pecans in Georgia. He was saying 75% of the pecans in Georgia are from what location is that from?
Well, I didn't completely hear all of the questions.
It kind of broke up a little bit on us.
But I think what you were asking was about the size of the crop in Georgia.
Yeah.
The crop in the United States is about 275 million pounds per year. Of that 275 million pounds, about 80 million pounds is grown in the state of Georgia. And again, it changes year to year. They have off years and on years. But more or less, Georgia is the number one grower of pecans in the United States. And of that $275 million, I'd also mention that that's about 90% of the world crop. So 90% of the pecans grown in the world are grown right here in the United States.
Wow.
And Georgia's number one.
Well, we have another caller on the line. While I'm adding this butter to this caramel, that's starting to get good, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
We have another caller on the line. Caller from Daytona Beach. What's your question for us?
Well, hello, this is Anne-Marie from Daytona Beach.
Hey, Anne-Marie.
And I sure am enjoying your show, especially
Thank you.
That bacon.
Everybody here is going to run for
it. I'm curious, what kind of variety of a pecan tree would I maybe want to grow as a homeowner, perhaps one or two in my yard?
Okay.
Yard.
That's a great question. There are about 200 varieties, actually more than that. There are about 200 varieties of pecans that grow in the United States right now. But only about four or five varieties, I would say, are capable of growing in this state, mostly because of the scab issue that I mentioned earlier. We have such high humidity here that the fungal disease we have, the scab disease, is a real problem that has to be sprayed continuously. So I would say that the two that I've got here, the Cape Fear and the Elliot, are your best bets. Moreland is another one that grows in this area. So those are three that I would recommend. The theory is that you need to have two different varieties, a type one and a type two, with regard to pollination. I would suggest that based on my experience, that's not necessarily true. You could probably plant two or three Elliot trees and be fine.
Well, we're going to finish up this recipe right here. And what I've done here, I got the caramel. You can see how it's done. This is it. You really don't have to do anything special with this. Now I added the pecans to it. I mean, that smells pretty good, doesn't it? And then all you have to do, this is finished. I take, scoop up, get you some tart shells already in the store. And guess what? You just made a tart. And if you want to make a pie, just get a pie shell. And here we go. How hard was that? I mean, it took like
even
five
I could
or six
do that.
Minutes to prepare that. It didn't take very long. We're getting ready to do another dish here in just a minute. Now, what I'm going to do is take these dishes, and I went ahead and made some whipped cream to top it with. Got to have whipped cream. Now, you
Absolutely.
Can buy whipped cream in a grocery store and all that. Just buy some heavy cream, put it in the mixer, and mix it. My goodness gracious. And all you have to do is, oh, look at that. It's chocolate whipped cream. That's looking pretty good, isn't it?
These are for us, right?
Oh, yes. Well, I'm telling you, this is turning out better than I thought. Not really. It's, you know, it just amazes me when you talk to people about making a pecan pie, and then you put this tart together and say, boy, that was pretty quick, wasn't it? This is going to be a little bit hot, but, you know, you might want to taste that. Just taste it a little bit. I'll give you a little bit of cream. Well, okay. I'll cream these. Go ahead.
Okay. Man,
we got another phone call from Palm Coast. Mm. Wait a second. I'm eating, okay?
Very good.
Oh, man. Whoa. That's killer, isn't
Excellent.
It? That is really, really good. We got a caller from Palm Coast. I'm not hearing you. I'm sorry. Mark? Mark from Palm Coast. We're waiting on you, partner. Okay. Well, we're going to continue cooking. And now I'm going to make some fettuccine alfredo. And what I've done here, I have onions and I have some pecans cut up. I have some bacon. You know, bacon, we can't seem to get away from bacon. And we put it in here and we're going to kind of cook it down a little bit. We'll put this away. Okay, we got the recipe up for the fettuccine alfredo. It's 3/4 of a cup of chopped pecans, which are in here. We have fettuccine noodles, which I have pre-cooked. You know, don't have to watch it boil it. Butter, olive oil, bacon, half and half, And then what you do is you slice up your onions and you put your clove. It's all in here right now cooking. And you can hear it, can't you? And what we're going to do, we're going to add half and half to that. Now, you can add skim milk. You can add what you want. People tease me all the time. I use heavy cream when I can. So now this. And what's happening here is I'm just cooking this down till the vegetables kind of get soft and clear. Again, this is another simple dish. And we want to try to accent this pecans that we have. And let's see how much time we have here. With that. I gotta drink this water. I just had that pecan. Boy, those are looking good over there. Y'all can't have them. Stay away from them, okay? Okay, what I'm gonna do now is add some cream to this. I'm half and half.
Oh. That cooled it down.
Well, that not too shabby. Put that in there like that. And guess what? We have to add a little bit of this fat-free butter. Everybody teases me about that. Now put the butter in there. Now I've got the spray, but let me ask you something. Would you rather I spray it or put the butter in it? I'll see everybody said butter, okay? So I'm sorry, folks, that's what it is. Now I need to get this good and hot, and that's all you do. You put your ingredients inside, get the milk really good and hot. Once you get this nice and hot, we're gonna add the noodles to it.
Okay.
And it's done. It doesn't take long. We have another caller on the line from Ormond Beach. You smell this all the way down there, don't you? Gail from Ormond Beach?
I wish I could smell it.
Well, come
it
on down.
It smells good. It definitely smells good.
I'd like to know what the nutritional value and the fat content is, and also where you can purchase fresh, raw products.
Okay, well, the good news about pecans is that they're very high in the highest antioxidant count of any tree nut.
Yeah, that's what I've heard. They're very, very healthy.
So they're rich in antioxidants. They contain 19 minerals and vitamins.
Wow.
So I want you to remember that now.
Good.
I want you to remember that when your wife is giving you a hard time about going for that second piece of pie, I want you to tell her I'm just loading up on my vitamins.
I hate to tell you this. She doesn't say anything to me about eating. Because if I'm cooking for her, she's going to get what I get.
Nuts have a very high, pecans have a very high mineral and vitamin content and antioxidant. As far as where you can get fresh ones around here other than my place, which are not for sale right now, I don't have an answer other than to go up to Georgia. There are some places just north of the borderline where folks are selling pecans and you can get them.
Are the seasons different on pecans across the country?
Mostly not. The pollination occurs in March, and I start picking in mid-September. It's about a six-month process. The pollination starts a little bit later up in Georgia.
See, this
place
is coming to a boil now, okay? Now, we're going to do this one more time. Look at that. Doesn't that? It's not even close to being done, but it's almost done. Now we're going to add our noodles to this. Again. Okay, we're going to heat this up. And then once we get this nice and heated, I'm going to go ahead and add some eggs to it. And we need to get this to a nice boil before we do that. And there we go. Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. From South Daytona, we have a call. June?
Hi, Chef Costa.
Hi.
I love your show.
Thank you very much. We love you listening and watching and telling your friends, please.
My question is for Mr. Barrett. I was wondering where his farm is located and where he sells his pecans.
Yeah, people keep asking where the farm is located. They want to come see you.
We're just north of the land, north end of Volusia County. Unfortunately, I've not had a position where I'm selling them yet because I don't have enough of a crop. What's interesting about pecans is it takes about 5 years to get your first crop. I've been doing it about 10 years, and we're just getting to the point where we have 50 to 100 pounds of crop a year. But we're not quite at that point yet where we're selling commercially. I hope to be there next year.
Well, we're kind of winding down here. I want to show you this fettuccine Alfredo dish. See, it's done. I added cheese to it. I put raw eggs and stirred it up real quick. It's a done deal. It's ready to serve, which is kind of nice.
It sure smells good.
It really does, doesn't it? You know, I really had fun talking with you tonight about the show and everything. Everybody's going to be jumping all over this in a few minutes. I can tell you that. Okay, well, I want to thank you, Michael, for coming down. I really learned a lot about pecans and everything. So
appreciate you having me.
We're out of time. I want to thank the viewers and my special guest, Mike, of course. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Local Flavor. Be sure to be like our Facebook page. Get to that Facebook page and say, like us, and check the recipes on there. Also, check our Local Flavor recipes that are on there from the past. Make sure to tune in next time for another episode of Local Flavor.